Mom. I wish I had more time to give to it.
You give 3 nights a week to it.
Well, you don't mind, do you, Mom?
No, but I think it's foolish going without your lunch every day to buy dance tickets.
I'd rather dance than eat lunch any time. And I'm good, Mom. You promised to come up to the dance hall some night to see me on the floor with Tracy Nolan. Guys, you'd be proud of me.
Very likely I would, son.
Someday, da-da.
Who is Tracy Nolan?
One of the hosts up to the dance hall. She's the best dancer there, and we sure look swell together.
Is she pretty?
Oh, yeah. She's beautiful, Mom, and nice, too. Awfully sweet and kind of innocent-like. She follows like nothing in the world.
Follows?
Yeah. Just let you lead her to into anything.
Why, Tommy, what kind of a girl is she?
Oh, Mommy, you don't understand. I mean, she lets you lead into any step.
Oh, I see. What are you looking for?
All my hair first.
Your what?
My Vaseline, to make my hair stay put.
Here, Tommy, get out of the way and let me find it.
I'll bet I know where it is. That spice soda jerker has borrowed it.
Be careful now what you say about Ernie. He pays us $6 a week for his room, you know. And he needs it.
Okay, Mom.
Is that you, Smith Hip? Can the wise crack, Jack Gilbert?
Oh, now don't get sore, young fella. You ready to go? And lay off my bandoline. Thanks, sweetheart. I just barred it to fill a cavity in my tooth.
Yeah? Well, you better find something to fill a cavity in your head.
Well, I suppose you know, Mrs. Flynn, your little boy is likely to bring home another cup tonight.
Yes. I wish they'd give away a side of ham or something useful in place of cups. Look at them. You can't.
Show them all how to use their feet.
You ought to be proud. Some mothers would get all hot and bothered over their son winning 14 silver cups.
Yes, I get all hot and bothered, all right. Every time I polish them.
Come on, step on the gas, sweetheart. I gotta mix fresh raspberry goo before the bar opens.
Hey! Huh. These ain't ashtrays. You don't know what to do with your cigarette ashes, stick them in your pocket.
Oh, I think I was going to hurt them. Why don't you take all the cups and pin them on your watch chain?
Now, stop your fussing. Don't stay out too late, Tommy.
Can't. Just got enough money for the contest and 3 other dances. I'll be home plenty early.
He'll be home early, unless he takes Miss Gracie Nolan home to Glendale.
She don't live in Glendale, you cute little cut-up. She's taking a room over near the dance hall, Mom.
So long.
Bye, Mom.
Goodbye, son.
Bye, Miss Flynn.
Hey, Ernie, listen.
What?
After I finish dancing with Gracie tonight, I want to buy her a soda or something.
Yeah?
Well, I've only got enough money for one.
Well, maybe she won't want any more than one.
No, Ernie. I mean, I don't want to buy one for myself, just one for her.
Oh, well.
Well, I can't very well say that I don't want anything, or she won't order anything. But I got an idea. I'll order a nut sundae, and you say, well, I'm just fresh out of nuts. And I'll say, well, maybe I won't have anything then. And then you just give her a soda, see?
Okay, I understand. Say, it's certainly tough keeping up with this society racket, ain't it?
You said it, boy. Would you like to have some ice cream?
Yeah. Thanks.
You this beautiful maid.
You can put lots of ice cream in my chocolate soda.
Right. And you, Mr. Bandoline?
Oh, I'll have a nut sundae.
Very appropriate. Just a moment.
That is, if you have any nuts.
Oh, we've got plenty of nuts.
Well, maybe I won't have a nut sundae.
Oh, sure you will. It's great for what ails you.
And I'll bring our refreshments.
All right, let's.
All right. I'll be back soon and take a few breaks.
Hey, son. Hey, how about them drinks? That'll be 30 bird seed, Mr. Rockfellow.
For what?
For what? Well, if Mrs. Flynn's only son isn't getting dumped, a nut sundae and a chocolate soda adds up to 30 whole pennies.
Why, there must be some mistake, my good man. All I owe is 15 cents for the soda. I didn't order the nut sundae.
You what?
Wait a minute, Ray, what's the trouble here?
Well, this young soda dispenser thought I ordered the nut sundae, but I didn't.
You're a fine cheese of peas. Listen, if you made up a thing the gentleman didn't order, you pay for it yourself out of your own pocket. We can't afford to waste any profits around here, you know.
But here you are, my boy.
You know the rules of the house as well as I do. The help stands responsible for all their own mistakes.
But listen,
now, listen, don't talk anymore about it. Put the money in the till. From your own pocket, put it in the till. Go ahead.
Well, hit me with a Mack truck.
Oh, Ernie didn't have any more nuts, and I didn't want anything else.
Oh.
You know, Gracie, I wouldn't come to this dance hall if you weren't here.
You better tell that to Mr. Bremer. Maybe he'll give me a raise.
I think I've met the girl I've been dreaming about. Think she's a man.
Well, sister, you're the only little package this garden makes me want to dance. Let's go out and do a couple of...
If you don't stay away from me, I'm going to knock you into so many pieces you think you were stuck together.
such a fighter as this, ain't it? Huh? You come in here again and I'll throw you out twice as much as I did this time.
Guys, that was swell of you. And you sure can't fight, Mr. Well, my name's Tommy Flynn.
Glad to know you, Mr. Flynn.
And this is Tracy Nolan.
And very glad to know you, Miss Nolan. My name's Ted Smith.
How do you do? And thanks awfully for sending me to that cave man.
Oh, not at all. It's good I didn't miss, or he might have cleaned up the place with me.
Oh, he didn't have a chance with you. Say, you're Ted Smith the Flyer, aren't you? Didn't I see you spinning out over Carter Field a week ago Sunday?
Oh, the day my left wing cracked?
Yes! Guys, didn't the crowd go wild when you made that trick landing? Guys, you were wonderful.
Oh, I got a lucky break that day.
Well, you're the famous flyer that we read about in the newspapers.
Well, not so famous, but I've made the headlines a couple of times. Say, why don't you and Mr. Flynn come out to the field tomorrow afternoon? I do some stunts every Sunday.
Say, that'd be great.
Oh, I'd love to go.
Dancing contest!
Like to dance?
Oh, I'd love to, don't you?
I'm going to. Nice.
Oh, you know all the right answers, don't you?
Sure. And I know all the right questions, too.
Meaning?
There's one I'm going to ask you before long.
My, you are a fast worker, aren't you?
You have to be in my racket. You know, there ain't no tomorrow for a pilot. Bashful, baby.
You haven't gotten into any trouble, have you?
No, nothing like that. Gee, Mom, I wish I could make some more money.
You will someday, son.
Yeah, but I need it now.
What do you need it now for?
Well, when a fella's thinking about getting married, he's got to have enough money to be able to feed and dress a girl.
Married? Why, Tommy, don't tell me that you're thinking of getting married.
Well, you can't be tarred and feathered for thinking.
But you hardly make ends meet as it is.
Well, Mom, what I was really thinking, maybe Gracie wouldn't mind getting engaged to me until I got a raise.
Oh, so it's Gracie, is. Well, she won't mind if she's the right sort and loves you.
Well, Gracie kind of thinks she likes me like a brother. But I'm sure if she knew how much I love her, she'd change. But every time I go to tell her, my tongue just lays dead.
You mustn't be so meek.
Wow, Mom, I just got an idea. Listen, tonight's country snort, I at the dance hall. and you come along with me and make like that you just came to win a ham or something, then I'll introduce you to Gracie, and I'll leave you two alone, see? And you get Gracie into the conversation and wind up by telling her how much I love her.
Why, Tommy, I couldn't do that.
Oh, Mom, you're not going to walk out on me now, are you?
Well, all right, I will.
Hey, listen, for Pete's sake, don't go telling me to blow my nose in front of Gracie or telling her what a cute little baby I was.
Tommy, I know better than that.
Oh, Mom, you're the sweetest mom that ever came across the pike.
That isn't tasty. It's none of my business, and of course you know what to do. But it strikes me that you fell in love with this big Amos. What kind of a fellow is this high flyer?
Oh, Papa Bemis. He's everything that's wonderful.
Well, when a girl like you thinks such a much of a fellow, he must be all right. And I have no critics. I have nothing to say about it.
When you get to know him, I know you'll just love
it. We love him. Arnold the dancer might, but not me.
Have you seen Mr. Ted Smith tonight?
Not yet, Gracie.
Mom, you sit right here and you can see everything.
Oh, I'm all excited, son. I don't blame you for liking to come here. It's nice.
There she is, Mom. Hey, Gracie. This is Miss Gracie Nolan, Mom. You've heard me speak of her.
Yes, I think I have. Pleased to meet you, Miss Nolan. Oh, I've heard lots about you, Mrs. Flynn. Tommy said you taught him to dance when he was a baby. Oh, it wasn't hard to teach him to do anything. He was such a smart baby. And he was so cute. You know, when he was just a little tot.
Well, you'll have to excuse me. I've got to speak to Ernie about something.
Sure. Don't be long, Tommy.
I won't.
Won't you sit down, Miss Nolan?
Thanks.
Tommy's talked about you so much that I feel that I've known you for a long time. Now that you really know me, I hope you won't be disappointed. My dear child, I can see that you're everything that Tommy thinks you are. Sure sounds nice to hear someone like you say nice things about me. It sounds sort of real. And it's awfully nice of Tommy to think I'm aces. Oh, Tommy thinks you're just wonderful. And you know, Miss Nolan, Tommy's going to get somewhere in the world. He's going to make something of himself.
I sure he will.
I hope you don't think I'm just a silly mother raving over my son this way. But I've watched Tommy closely. He's going to make a wonderful husband.
You can say that again. The girl that gets Tommy sure will be lucky.
Gee. I just hope he gets everything in the world he wishes for. Oh, I'm so happy to hear you say that. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. The real reason I came here tonight was to meet you and... Oh, Mrs. Flynn, someone I've been waiting to see just came in. I'm awfully sorry. I hope you'll excuse me. You'll come back, won't you?
Sure, I'll see you before you leave.
Were you looking for someone, mister?
Hello, baby. How are you?
Fine.
Today I've got more news to tell you than a Sunday edition. Is there a spot around this joint where we can be alone?
Oh, yes, let's go to the loggia.
Great.
Care to check your hat, sir?
Oh, yes, thanks. Come on.
Hey there, old man Flynn.
What do you have, son?
Say, little boy, you look like you've just been elected president.
Well, if everything works out all right tonight the way I hope it will, I might run for president.
Well, if you're feeling that big, how about kicking in with that 15 cents you owe me?
Sure, after I'm elected president, boy.
Before you say another word, Ted, I want to thank you for the break.
Oh, never mind about the bracelet, baby. Just get ready to listen to the greatest break Ted Smith ever got.
What is it?
The pilot who was supposed to leave tomorrow at daybreak on a nonstop trip across the country cracked up today, and I'm going to take his place.
You mean you're leaving in the morning?
Yeah, a nonstop trip to make a record.
Oh, Ted, I'm scared.
Don't be silly, honey. It's a great break for me. Why, I've been asking them to let me try it for months.
How long will you be gone?
Oh, about 10 days.
Oh, Ted, dear, anything happened to you in one of those planes, I don't know what I'd do. Even when I just think about it, I get sort of crazy and weak all over.
Oh, come on, kid. You've got more nerve than that. Why, just think of all the fun we'll have when I get back.
How'd you make out, Mom?
Why, Tommy Flynn, you ought to be ashamed of yourself for being such a mollycoddle. That girl thinks the world of you.
She does?
Why, she told me herself she thinks you'd make a wonderful husband.
You mean you spoke to her about getting engaged to me?
Well, I didn't get that far, because somebody came that she had to see. But you won't find any trouble, son. All you have to do is to ask her.
Oh, gee, Mom, I'm so happy.
So am I, Tommy. Oh, she's just wonderful and so sweet.
Well, I'll ask her right now. Which way'd she go?
Over that way.
All right, Mom, wait here.
Gosh, I wish you weren't going, darling.
Oh, but you love me, don't you?
Oh, so much, Ted, dear.
Well, then you certainly wouldn't want me to pass up an opportunity like this. Oh, come on, baby. Buck up now. Oh, hello, Tommy.
Hello.
Gee, I've got great news. I'm leaving in the morning on a nonstop trip across the country.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, and little Gracie here, why, she's scared to death. You know, we're kind of daffy about each other. I kind of feel tough about going and leaving her, too.
Yeah, Tommy, I'm awful frightened.
Oh, don't be frightened, Gracie. Nothing will happen to Ted.
Why, you take good care of Gracie while I'm gone, won't you, Tommy?
Sure I will, Ted.
Oh, sweetheart, I've got to get out to the field and get some instructions. You ride out with me, won't you?
Sure, but I got to get my coat, and I'll meet you at the front entrance.
All right. Come on, Tommy. I'm glad I've got a friend like you to leave Gracie with. Gee, you're a great kid, Tommy.
I'm glad you think so, Ted. I'm kind of proud to be a friend of yours, too.
Ah.
Well, goodbye, Ted. And lots of luck to you.
Oh, I'm a cinch, Tommy. So long.
That aviator friend of mine I was telling you about.
Oh, did you see Gracie?
Yeah. Mom, they're playing a waltz now. Will you dance with me?
Oh, Tommy. I haven't danced for so long. I'm afraid.
Oh, don't be afraid. You just follow me and do what I do, and everything will be great.
everything is swell.
And did you talk about the engagement?
Well, when you see Gracie, it's awfully sad because I love her. But she wanted more time to think it over.
Just like I said, son. She'll say yes.
See what the paper said? I told you there was nothing to worry about.
Oh, I saw that. Gee, that's the worst part of it, sitting around waiting for the newspaper to tell you whether he's safe or not.
Ah, sure, he's safe. You make yourself nervous prostration if you don't snap away from it. I bet you by now he's in Hoboken or somewhere. That fella could fly with one wing and a broken tail.
Be back soon, talking to you and sitting close to you and holding you tight, just like I am now.
Remember, Charlie, I leave it up to you to regulate the dancing here. We don't want any of this cheek-to-cheek foxtrot business, you understand? You instruct the dancers that the gentleman must keep a little farther away from the lady than the lady is from the gentleman, see?
But, Mr. Brimmer, how can the gentleman stay a little further away from the
now,
lady?
Say, listen, never mind how he can do it. That's the way it's got to be done, you understand?
Yes, sir, yes.
Extra paper!
Remember?
Extra paper!
All about the airplane crash! Ted Smith, plane missing! Extra paper!
Remember?
Oh,
what's the
tonight, Phil.
Oh, yes, you do.
What?
Let me see that paper.
What paper? Say, listen, what's the matter with you? Are you crazy? That's an old newspaper I got, and I'm going to wrap up a couple of sandwiches, and that's all. Now, don't bother me.
Oh,
I want
give it to
now,
me that
please, I'm Gracie. No, please, oh, Gracie, don't read that.
Gosh, Mr. Bremer, we'd better send for a doctor.
Yeah, but see if he can't bring, get it conscientious, but bring her, you know, make her awake again.
The heck of it is, she's got no one to look after. It looks like she's in for a long spell.
Gee, that's right. Hey, don't you think it'd be a good idea if I took her home to my house? And then Mom could look after her then.
Gee, that'd be grand.
Yeah, that's a great idea. Let's do that right away. Look, I'll telephone for a doctor and get a taxi cab.
Even before the doctor is.
When
I telephone, he just
couldn't
be there.
Don't
the doors open, Mr.
Bremer. Take it easy now, Tommy. Take it easy.
Why, Tommy, what's the matter?
Mom, has the doctor come yet?
Doctor? What doctor?
All right, I telephoned for a doctor. He'll be here in a few minutes.
I'll explain it all, Mom. Open the door early, Ruben.
Have you got any smelling salts?
Yes, Mr. Bremer, I have.
That's a good thing. Some smelling salts have you got?
Oh, gee, Mom. I wish you'd open her eyes.
For heaven's sake, Tommy, can't you go out
of the house?
Good evening. I'm Dr. Loring.
Well, come right in, Doctor. She's right over in this room over here. Here's your doctor.
Ah, Doctor, how you are?
Hello, Mr. Bremer, how are you?
Oh, I'm fine. It's the little girl here. She heard some bad news and she went unconscious like that. Mm. Doctor, now listen, I want you to give her all your attention. See that she gets everything she wants. Spare no expense and send the bill to me. Good night, Doctor. I gotta get back to the hall. Good night, Mrs. Spinn. I know you don't want to depend on.
Good night.
Gee, Mr. Bremer, that was
No, don't worry, Tommy. Everything's all right. He's a fine doctor. She'll be all right. I come to see Gracie every day that she gets back.
Good night.
Good night, Mr. Bremer.
Very serious, Doctor.
It's a heart caused by a shock. Too much for her. She'll need a complete rest for a few weeks and absolute quiet. Another shock like last night might prove dangerous.
I'll open the door for her.
Good night, son.
Good night.
Don't let it worry you. You'll come out all right.
Why, tell me what's happened. What caused the shock to Gracie?
Well, you see, about a half hour ago, an extra came out reporting that that flyer friend of mine, crashed somewhere in Kansas, and they haven't found any trace of him yet. And when little Gracie read the headlines, she just went all to pieces and fainted.
Oh, the poor child. Is she related to Ted?
No, Mom. She and Ted are crazy about each other.
Crazy about each other? Why, I thought you told me last night.
I know I lied last night, Mom. I didn't want to worry or hurt you.
Oh, Tommy.
Well, don't feel sorry for me. Poor Gracie that needs someone and somebody's sympathy. I'll be all right. She's going to be pretty sick. That's why I brought her home. She has to have the kind of care that you can give her. You heard what the doctor said. She's in a pretty bad way.
But, Sonny, where are we going to put her?
Well, Ernie will just have to move and we'll keep Gracie in there.
What are we going to do without
Now, listen, I'll work nights and make up the difference, Mom. Don't you see? I promised Ted the last thing. I'd look after Gracie. And what's more, Mom, you know, I love Gracie so. But you mustn't tell her ever.
All right, son.
Gee, I'll work so hard at night, and we won't need earning $6 a week, so don't you worry. I'm going in to see Gracie.
Oh, no, no, you mustn't. The doctor was so bad until she opened her eyes. Then she looked around the room kind of funny, didn't say anything, and went right back to sleep. So let her rest, Tommy.
Mom, we've got to make Gracie well.
We will, Tommy.
Gee, Mom, you're disaster, that's all.
Hi, Sam.
Hello, Bart. How are you tonight?
Okay.
Hello, Ernie.
Hi, Smitty. Well, there goes the curtain back on another night's labor. Stranger himself.
Hello, Ernie. Just thought I'd look in at the old place before I went home to dinner.
Well, I must say, everybody around here misses you. Why don't you drop in tonight?
Can't. Gotta work after dinner. 2 hours of bookkeeping yet.
Say, I guess Gracie's feeling much better.
Yeah.
Now that Ted's back.
What? Did you say Ted's back?
Why, sure, you don't mean to tell me you didn't know it. Well, he's been back for 2 days.
Oh, you're not kidding, are you, Ernie?
Why, of course not. Hasn't he been over to see Gracie?
Oh, sure. I guess he has during the day. But you see, by the time I get home from work, Gracie's usually asleep and I don't get a chance to talk to her. Say, I'd like to see Ted and say hello before I go home. You don't know where I can get him, do you?
Well, yeah, he was sitting at the counter the other night telling a couple of guys he was stopping at the Albemarle Apartments.
Thanks, Tony. I guess I'll be going.
Say, listen, Tommy, why don't you drop around tonight?
No, I can't. I'm too darn tired. Gotta hit the hay. So long, Ernie.
So long, kid.
Had a baby. Papa must have his milk.
Oh, Ted, I hope it'll always be like this.
Well, see who's at the door, will you, Bea?
It's Tommy Flynn.
Tommy Flynn? Two to one, he's come up here to cry about that schoolgirl, Gracie. Plead with me to go out and see her. Listen, Dee, I'll slip in the bedroom, and you tell him anything, only get rid of him.
Okay, honey.
Oh, hello, Bee.
Hello, Tommy. What brings you here?
Well, I was looking for Ted Smith, and the lady downstairs told me that this was Ted's apartment.
Well, this is Ted's apartment, but he isn't here right now.
Well, but what are you doing? I mean, do you know what time I can see Ted?
Oh, I don't know. He may be at the dance hall later on.
Well, thank you.
Milk while I get Tommy's supper ready.
Hello,
Hello, Gracie.
Hello, you hard-working businessman.
Hello, Mom.
Hello, Doc. Charlie, I'm in the test.
No, Gracie, no news.
I sort of hope you'd think of stopping by the dance hall on your way home. Maybe someone there heard of those tests.
Sorry, Gracie, but I haven't had time to stop by the old place.
Tell me. Come here a minute.
What?
Sit down, I want to talk to you. Tommy. Did you write this on the picture?
Well, yes. But let's don't talk.
Come on, tell me. Is that how you feel?
Well, if you must know, Gracie, yes, I love you. Tried awful hard to tell you about it a couple of times. But when I found out you loved Ted, I made up my mind I'd never tell you.
Gosh, I'm awful, awful sorry, Tommy. But you remember one time we talked about dreaming with our eyes wide open? And I said if I ever met the man that I dreamed of, he'd mean everything in the world to me. Well, that man, Ted.
I know.
Gee, Tommy, I'd like to make you happy, but it just can't be. Can't you forget all about me?
Sure, Gracie. Don't worry. I'll get over it. It ain't that bad. Well, I just ought to get cleaned up for dinner.
Come in.
Hello, Miss Gravy.
Papa Trevor.
Well, how you are? Looking better. My goodness. They're studying hard, eh? Well, I'm glad to hear you're doing so well with your lessons.
Lessons?
Yeah, the doctor said your convalescence was wonderful. I went to a flower place and I bought you some you know, some of the chocolate flowers. thank you. The terrible thing is, flowers that cost too much money to have such an awful name.
Oh, they're beautiful.
Yeah.
Won't you sit down?
you little faker, certainly not. think I'm going to spoil your evening? You know, I know when people want to be alone. Don't you worry, I'll be out of here before Ted comes.
Ted?
Yeah.
Ted's back?
Yeah, you know he's back, all right. Don't look such an innocent. You know, a couple of days ago when Ted got here, I... Gracie. You don't need to tell me that Ted hasn't been over to see you.
What? No.
What an old fool I am. How could he? He doesn't even know where you're living. If he comes tonight to the hall, I'll tell him. And then you just watch him come running, eh? I'll tell him.
Oh, Papa Bella.
Right.
Does Tommy know that Ted's back?
Sure. That is me. I don't... Maybe. I'm not sure. Well, good night, Crazy. I'll drop around tomorrow sometime and see how you are. Good night.
Come on.
Tommy, where are you going?
I'm going to find Ted Smith and bring him here.
Listen, don't bother me with Arnold and Dalton. I got something else to worry about. When they come, don't let them in. You understand? I'm through with them. Oh, what a schlemiel I am. If I live 100 years, I'll never get that poor little girl's mind out of my face. The way she looked when I told her the Ted was back already. Listen, if you see that loafer, you tell him that I want to see him. I'll bet you I give him a couple of pieces of my mind.
Okay.
You gotta come over here right now and see Gracie.
Why, don't be silly. Why should I want to see Gracie?
Well, you told her you loved her and a lot of other things, didn't you?
Say, you kids have got me all wrong. I liked her all right. Why, she was a cute little number, but a little too inexperienced for me.
Well, she's been sick all on account of you. You told her you loved her, and she's thinking you're coming home right now. And you're gonna go home right now if I have to knock you down and drag you.
Say, wait a minute. Take your hands off of me, you sap.
Say, wait till I get at that big bozo, I'll knock him cold.
Hey,
you're everything he's having twice as much. You're a dirty, rotten. There isn't anything rotten that you ain't. If I had a son like you, I'd trade him for a yellow dog, and then I'd shoot the dog. Now get out of here. Get out before I forget myself and say something unkind to you.
That's okay with me, only you don't need to yell so loud.
I can yell as loud as I want to.
Oh, drop and bust before you throw an epileptic fit.
If I had an epileptic fit. If I had one of these things, I'd throw it in his face. Now get out! Get out before I forget myself and worry about the way you fight the leash.
Now please, everyone, go away. Will you please, everyone?
Well, you turned out to be a great help, didn't you?
Ernie, are you hurt much?
Who hit me from behind?
Nobody hit you there. You fell on it.
Come on, Ernie. Get up.
Come on. Take him away. Go on. Try it. Come on, baby.
No, this way, Ernie. This way.
Go on. Outside.
Oh, Ted. You're back, and you're all right. I thought you'd been killed.
Just a minute, Gracie. There's something a little cockeyed about your dope sheet. Tell her what, Ted. What is it? Tell me, Ted.
Well, gee, Gracie, I didn't know you took me seriously. Why, I thought you were kidding along, same as I was.
Kidding along?
Well, yes, gee, I didn't know you misunderstood, kid. Why, I thought you knew your way around. B here had first claim on me. Why, we were old sweethearts and... Oh, well, you know, we sort of made it up again, didn't we, B?
Oh, I beg your pardon. I have been mistaken. I thought you were a man, not just a cheap thrill hunter. A cheap girl chaser.
Oh, gee. Gracie, don't take it that way. Why, we can still be good friends.
Friends? Only a two-faced, conceited imitation like you could possibly think such a thing.
Oh, come on, Ted.
All right.
Crazy? I see you talking with that foreclosure. You know now. Everything. That's right, mein lieber Kind. Have a good cry, and then you feel better. Now, there's plenty happiness left in the world, and you'll find your share. You know, some great philosopher once said, there never was a tear shed so big, but what there's a dimple in some cheek, deep enough to hold it. No,
but I've been so blind.
We got no more time for any more sentimentals now. Now, listen. You come with me, Gregory. I got something very, very important to say to you. And somebody else. Come on.
If I ever bump into that guy again, I'll bet you I knock him so flat he'll look like he's been run over by a steamroller.
Yes, Tommy. You can beat that bird up any time.
This is Boyce. Justine, beat it. I want to have a private conversation with these two kids.
Oh, Tommy, what's happened to you?
Now, listen. Never mind what happened to him. But listen to what's going to happen to both you hookers. And don't give me any argument about it. I've fired Arnold and Dalton because they made arguments with me. And the team that's going to take their place beginning tonight is Gracie Nolan and Tommy Flynn. At a salary of $200 a week. Whether you like it or not.
What a schlemiel I was to think that I was a schlemiel.
Well, Tommy, I'm awfully sorry this happened.
Well, you got your wish, didn't you? You beat me.
Well, Tommy, can you ever forgive me? I just found out everything. You're the man I dreamed about with my eyes wide open. And I never knew it. And you were alongside of me all the time.
Pinch me, Gracie. I'm afraid I'm dreaming.
Oh, no, you're not, Tommy. I love you. And nothing, nobody but you will ever mean a thing to me.
Ouch!
Did I hurt you, Tommy?
Gracie, you can never hurt me.